floor that's aimed toward the children. So I'd ask, as we've done before, I'd ask all the children to come up in front here, right in front of me, if they can come up here, all the children right up here, because this sermon is for you. So I want you to be front and center. All the Sunday school age children, if they can come up here. And we're going to talk a little bit about the season that we're in. We all know what season we're in, right? The world calls it the Christmas shopping season, right? And I don't know about you, but every day when I go out to my mailbox, I have a stack of Christmas shopping catalogs. The world is trying to get us to buy all these things, right? And the world is asking us to buy these things as gifts for each other, right? This is the Christmas gift season. And I'm sure you've all put together your Christmas lists, the things that you're hoping to get this Christmas. And you're anxiously awaiting Christmas when you can open all these gifts that you've received. And hopefully you will receive all the things you've asked for on your Christmas list. And where did this idea of gift giving come from? Right, we all know the story, right? When Christ was born, there were wise men from the East who came to see the Christ child. And they brought gifts. So that's where this came from. But did they bring gifts for each other? Did they all sit around the manger and open gifts for each other? No. Who did they bring those gifts for?
Jesus.
For Jesus, for Christ. So during this season, when we're all thinking about gifts, we should be thinking about what gifts we're going to give to Christ. Because Christ has given us his Christmas list. And he reminds us of that list several times through the year. What are the things that Christ asks for? First of all, he asks that we love him, that we love the Lord our God with all our heart, soul, and mind. And what does that mean? That means that we come to church, that we follow his commandments, that we come and receive his body and blood. We take communion. That's how we show our love for Christ. And the second thing he asked for is that we love our neighbor as ourselves. So what does that mean, to love our neighbor? Well, Christ gave us several examples himself. We all know the story of the Good Samaritan, right? Where the Good Samaritan took care of an injured person on the road, right? And Christ gives us several examples of that, how we can love our neighbor. And he also gives us examples how not to love our neighbor. And last week's gospel is a good example of that. You remember last week's gospel? There was a farmer who had a barn or barns full of grain, and he had more grain than can fit in his barn. So what did he say? He said, "I'm going to build more barns." Right? All for himself. And he's going to eat, drink, and be merry. Was he loving his neighbor?
No.
Right? So we may say to ourselves, "Well, I'm not a farmer. I don't have a barn full of grain." Well, maybe not. But maybe you have a closet full of clothes that you don't wear anymore. Or a toy box full of toys that you don't play with anymore. Maybe you should be thinking about giving those away to someone who can use them. You know, St. Basil the Great said, if you have a coat in your closet that you're not wearing, it doesn't belong to you. It belongs to the person who needs it. So maybe during this season, you could be going through the things you have and deciding what someone else could make better use of than you are. If you know someone like that, you can give those things to them. You can give them to charity. But that's loving our neighbor. Realizing we have things that we don't need and giving them to someone who has a greater need than we do. Let's think of some other examples. At school, maybe there's a kid at school that really needs a friend. You know, Christ said, we should give to those that are the least of these, my brothers. So don't just look to be friends with the popular kids. They have plenty of friends. Look for the kids that don't have friends. Maybe they're not good at sports, or maybe they have some disability, or maybe they're new to the school. Look for those kinds of kids that don't have friends and be a friend to them. That's loving our neighbor as ourselves. Let me give another example. Their liturgy will be over soon. We'll all be going next door to coffee hour, right? And I don't know what we're having today. Let's just suggest maybe we're having fish. And let's say we're really hungry. And so I say, I'm going to have 2 pieces of fish. Well, wait a minute. Look around. Maybe there's, I'm just throwing out numbers. Maybe there's 40 people in line. And we see there's only about 40 pieces of fish. So if I take 2 pieces of fish, that means somebody's not going to get any. Because I'm taking their piece. So I say, okay, I'm only going to take one because there's only enough for one for each person. Even better, let me say, maybe I'm only going to take half a piece of fish. Why is that? Maybe someone will come in late. I'll leave the other half for them. That's loving our neighbor. Always thinking of someone else instead of ourselves. At home, there's so many examples at home where you can show love for our siblings, our brothers and sisters, for our parents. You know, when we finish a meal, let's say you've got something you want to go play in your room. Do you just jump up from the table and go run into your room? Or do you think, maybe I can help clean up the table before I go run to my room? There are lots of examples like that we could all, I'm sure, come up with. Ways that we show love for Christ. These are the things that are on Christ's Christmas list. And these are the things he looks for us to do, especially this season. You know, I think it's interesting this year that, you know, our pre-nativity or Christmas season is 40 days, right? And it started on the same day as Black Friday, right? The big shopping day. So during this season, when we're doing all this shopping and all our thinking about the gifts we're going to get on Christmas, let's also be thinking about the gifts we give to Christ. So actually today is the 10th day of that Christmas period. If you'll forgive a football analogy, this is the end of the first quarter. Okay? So we've got 3 quarters left. So let's think about, during that first quarter, did we give any gifts to Christ? Did we think about our brothers and sisters, our parents, those that we see around us, and did we think about their needs as much as ours? And if we haven't, if we can't quickly come up with an example, then let's start thinking about that. It's never too late to start. And let me also say, you're never too young. The nice thing about Jesus' Christmas list, you don't need a credit card to buy anything on it, right? You don't need an account on Amazon. You just need to be thinking about your brothers and sisters in Christ. Now I'm going to end with kind of a trick question. As you're all sitting here, how many icons of Christ do you see?
A lot.
Who can point to icons of Christ? There's one here, of course, right behind me. There's the one up here that we venerate all the time. There's a little one right here. Yeah, there's one up there. Very good. I'm looking to see if anybody's pointing up. If you look, some of you may not be able to see it too well because the chandelier's in the way, but there's one way up in the top of the dome.
I see.
Right? That's called the icon of Christ, Pantokrator, which means in Greek, the ruler of everything. He is the one that we come to this church to honor. We are Christians because of Christ. So we should be thinking about him every time we come to church. And as we come up to venerate his icon, we should be thinking about, what have I done? What gifts have I given to you, Christ? I'm here because of you. I'm a disciple of yours. And ask his forgiveness if there's any opportunity to give a gift to him that you've missed. Maybe there was an opportunity that you saw, but some temptation drew you away from it. Ask Christ's forgiveness for those things and strive to do better in the coming week, to think of those things where you can give gifts to Christ. And ask for his help, because he will help you to find those opportunities to give those gifts to him, to show love for our neighbor. But we have to take the initiative. We have to first think of ourselves in our minds and our hearts as Christians, as loving Christ. And that means we want to do those things he asks us to do, which means to love him with all our heart, soul, and mind, and to love our neighbors as ourselves. So let's vow to do that during these remaining few weeks of this Christmas period, and all throughout the year, but especially this time of year when we're thinking about giving gifts. Let's give gifts to Christ. Through the prayers of our Father, Lord Jesus Christ, our God, have mercy on us and save us. Amen.
The blessing of the Lord be upon you through his grace and love for mankind, always, now, and ever, and unto the ages of ages.
Amen.